हेलो फ्रेंड्स, आई एम शेफाली राहुल घुटके, एमटेक इन हाइड्रोलिक्स, करंटली वर्किंग एज एन असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर इन सिविल इंजीनियरिंग डिपार्टमेंट एट तुलसी रामजी गायकवाड़ पाटिल कॉलेज ऑफ इंजीनियरिंग एंड टेक्नोलॉजी. सो आई वेलकम यू ऑल इन टूडेज वीडियो लेक्चर विच इज़ बेस्ड ऑन रेसिप्रोकेटिंग पम्प. सो इन टूडेज लेक्चर वी विल गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट द वर्किंग ऑफ रेसिप्रोकेटिंग पम्प एंड इट्स मेन कंपोनेंट. So basically, pumps are used to convert the mechanical energy into the pressure energy. Basically, there are two types of pump. First one is centrifugal and the second one is reciprocating pump. In centrifugal pump, the mechanical energy is converted into the pressure energy by centrifugal force, whereas in reciprocating pump, mechanical energy is converted into the pressure energy by reciprocating motion of a piston. Okay, so the pumps are used to increase the energy level of the water by the virtue of which it can be raised to a higher level. Reciprocating pumps are positive displacement pump, that is, initially a small quantity of a liquid is taken into a cylindrical chamber and is physically displaced and forced out with the pressure by a moving mechanical elements. The use of reciprocating pump is being limited this day and being replaced by a centrifugal pumps. For the industrial purposes, they have become obsolete due to their high initial and maintenance cost as compared to the centrifugal pump. The small hand operated pumps are still in use, that includes the well pumps, etc. These are also useful where the high head are required with a small discharge as oil drilling operations. So let's discuss about the main components of reciprocating pump. A reciprocating pump consists of a plunger or a piston that moves forward and backward inside a cylinder with the help of connecting rod and a crank. The crank is rotated by an external source of power. The cylinder is connected to the sump by a suction pipe and to the delivery tank by a delivery pipe. At the cylinder end of this pipe, non-return valves are provided. A non-return valve allows the liquid to pass only in one direction. Through the suction valves, liquid can only be admitted into the cylinder, and through the delivery valve, liquid can only be discharged into the delivery pipe. So this is the single acting reciprocating pump. Okay, this is the sump level. Sump level, it means water is present. Okay, we can say that it is a small reservoir. This is the suction pipe. At the end of suction pipe, there is a suction valve. This is the cylinder. Inside the cylinder, there is a piston. Piston is connected to a piston rod, which is connected to a connecting rod, and the connecting rod is connected to a crank, which rotates in clockwise direction. Okay, so delivery pipe is connected to a cylinder, and this delivery pipe is connected to a overhead tank. At the sump level, the pressure is atmospheric. So the working of reciprocating pump: when the piston moves from left to the right, a suction pressure is produced inside the cylinder. If the pump is started for the first time or after a very long time, in that case, the air from the suction pipe is sucked during the suction stroke while the delivery valve is closed. So the liquid rises into the suction pipe by a small height due to the atmospheric pressure on the sump liquid. During the delivery stroke, air in the cylinder is pushed out into the delivery pipe by the thrust of the piston while the suction valve is closed. When all the air from the suction pipe has been exhausted, in that case, the liquid from the sump is able to rise and enters into the cylinder. During the delivery stroke, It is displaced into the delivery pipe. Thus, the liquid is delivered into the delivery tank intermittently, that is, during the delivery stroke only. Now, the classification of reciprocating pump. Following are the main types of reciprocating pump, which is according to the use of a piston size. First one is single acting reciprocating pump and the second one is double acting reciprocating pump. In single acting reciprocating pump, if there is only one suction, one delivery pipe and the liquid is filled only on one side of the piston, in that case the pump is called as single acting reciprocating pump. Whereas in double acting reciprocating pump, there are two suction, two delivery pipes and the liquid is receiving on the both side of the piston. Okay. So this is double acting reciprocating pump. As you can see in this picture, there are two suction pipe and two delivery pipe. Okay. Now the classification of a pump according to the number of a cylinder. So the reciprocating pump having more than one cylinder are called as multi-cylinder reciprocating pump. Single cylinder pump, a single cylinder can be either single or double acting. In double acting cylindrical pump, a double cylinder or two throw pump consists of a two cylinder connected to a same shaft. In double acting cylinder, there is a two cylinder which is connecting to a same shaft. Okay, now there is triple cylinder pump, three throw pump. A triple cylinder pump or the three throw pump has the three cylinder, the crank of which are set at 120 degree to one another. Each cylinder is provided with its own suction pipe, delivery pipe and piston. There can be four cylinder and five cylinder and many more. Okay, so the crank of which are arranged accordingly. So this is the triple cylinder pump in which these are three cylinders. Okay, these are the three cylinder which are connecting to a crank, and as you can see the crank is placed at 120 degree. Now the discharge through a reciprocating pump. Let us consider A is equal to cross sectional area of a cylinder, R is equal to crank radius, N speed of a pump in RPM, L is nothing but stroke length, which is 2R, discharge through the pump per second equal to area into stroke length into RPM divided by 60. So the theoretical discharge for reciprocating pump will be A into L into N divided by 60. So this will be the discharge when the pump is single acting. So this is the area of cylinder. This L is nothing but stroke length, which is equal to 2R. This D is nothing but the diameter, and this A is nothing but the area of a cylinder. This AP is nothing but area of a piston rod. Okay. So we can calculate the discharge for double acting reciprocating pump. In double acting reciprocating pump, the theoretical discharge will be equal to A ln by 60 plus A minus AP ln divided by 60. Okay, this AP is nothing but area of cross section of piston rod. So after simplifying, we will get 2A minus AP ln divided by 60. Okay, so the area, if we neglect the area of a piston, okay, in that case the theoretical discharge for double acting reciprocating pump will be 2A ln by 60. Thus, the discharge of a double-acting reciprocating pump is twice than that of a single-acting reciprocating pump. Owing to leakage losses and the time delay in closing the valves, actual discharge, which is small qa, usually lesser than that of theoretical discharge. If there are so many leakages and losses and delaying in closing of the valve, in that case the actual discharge, it will always be lesser than the theoretical discharge. So the slip of a reciprocating pump is defined as the difference between the theoretical and the actual discharge. It means the difference between the theoretical discharge and actual discharge ultimately gives slip of reciprocating pump. Okay, so the slip can also be expressed in terms of percentage, and which is given by percentage of slip is equal to Q theoretical minus Q actual divided by Q theoretical into 100. After simplifying it, we will get 1 minus Q actual divided by Q theoretical into 100. This Q actual divided by Q theoretical is nothing but coefficient of discharge, which is represented by CD. So we can write it as bracket 1 minus CD into 100. In slip, where CD is known as coefficient of discharge and is defined as the ratio of actual discharge to the theoretical discharge. Okay, so the value of CD when expressed in percentage is known as the volumetric efficiency of a pump. Its value usually ranges between 95% to 98%. The slip is of the order of 2% for the pump in good condition. Now, what is negative slip in reciprocating pump? It is not always that the actual discharge is lesser than the theoretical discharge. In so many cases, it may be possible that the actual discharge, it will be greater than the theoretical discharge. So, in case of reciprocating pump with a long suction pipe and short delivery pipe and which is running at a high speed, so the inertia force in the suction pipe becomes very large as compared to the pressure force on the outside of the delivery valve. Okay, so this opens the delivery valve even before the piston has completed its suction stroke. Thus, some of the water is pushed into the delivery pipe before the delivery stroke is actually commenced. This way, the actual discharge becomes more than the theoretical discharge. So, thus the coefficient of a discharge increases from 1 and the slip becomes negative. So, the power input for reciprocating pump, it will be, we are considering single acting reciprocating pump in which H suffix S is equal to suction head, or the difference in the level between the center line of a cylinder and the sump. HD is equal to delivery head, or difference in between the center line of the cylinder and the outlet of the delivery pipe. HST is equal to total static head. It is the summation of suction head and the delivery head. So we can calculate the theoretical work done for the reciprocating pump, which is equal to P into Q theoretical into G into HST. So we put the value of Q theoretical, which is ALN divided by 60, and HST is equal to HS plus HD. So the power input to the pump, it will be rho into bracket ALN by 60 bracket close into G bracket HS plus HD, which is static head. However, due to the leakages and the frictional losses, the actual power input, it will be more than the theoretical power. So the efficiency of a pump will be come into the formula. So the actual power input to the pump, it will become 1 divided by efficiency into rho bracket ALN by 60 into G into static head. So this is a problem based on reciprocating pump, in which 3-throw reciprocating pump delivering 0.1 meter cube per second of a water, it means discharge is given, static head is given as 100 meter, diameter of a cylinder and stroke length is given as 25 centimeter and 50 centimeter, losses are there, 1 meter losses in suction pipe and 16 meter losses in delivery pipe. Okay, and the velocity of a water in the delivery pipe is given as 1.4 meter per second. Efficiency is given 90% and slip is 2%. So we have to determine the speed of a pump and power required. So first write the given data. After that, as percentage of slip is given, in that case we can easily calculate speed of a pump. Once the speed of a pump is calculated, we can easily calculate static head. Okay, after the static head, we have to apply the formula of power required for the pump, and we can easily calculate the power required, specific speed and head. This is a comparison of centrifugal and reciprocating pump. Centrifugal pump requires steady and even flow, whereas reciprocating pump requires intermittent and pulsating flow. Centrifugal pump uses for large discharge and small head, whereas reciprocating pump used for small discharges but high head is present. Okay, so centrifugal pump can be used for a viscous fluid, example oil, muddy water. It is operated at a low cost. It can run at a high speed, can be coupled directly to the electric motor. Centrifugal pump requires low maintenance cost, periodic checkup is sufficient, compactless floor required. Low head pump have high efficiency. In centrifugal pump, uniform torque is required. Simple construction, less number of spare parts are needed. Reciprocating pump can handle pure water or less viscous liquid only, otherwise the valve give frequent trouble. It can be operated at a low speed, belt drive are necessary. Reciprocating pump requires high initial cost, high maintenance cost, and the frequent replacement of the parts are needed. Reciprocating pump needs 6 to 7 times area than for centrifugal pump. The efficiency of a low head pumps as low as 40% due to the energy losses. Reciprocating pump do not require uniform torque. The construction of reciprocating pump is very complicated. More number of spare parts are needed. So thank you so much for listening so carefully.